Let's study your body regions together.
I'm using Notability. So I've written the answers and then I've used the tape feature to cover them up so I can do active recall. Okay, let's see how much you know. The front of the head is the frontal region. The region of the head containing the brain is referred to as the cranial region. The face we refer to as the facial region. So far, so good, right? The mouth is oral. Now, I've marked with asterisks the ones that students struggle with the most. The chin is called the mental region. I always tell my students to think about that sculpture, The Thinker, to help you to remember that one. The correct term for the armpit region is axillary. So axillary is Latin. It probably derives from ala, meaning wing. This region, a lot of people know, is the brachial region. Most people know biceps brachii, a major muscle here. Brachial just means arm. Now this one, the front of the elbow, is not so well known. It's called the anticubital region. So cubital is Latin for elbow. Anti means in front of or before. So literally it means in front of the elbow. Now this region on both the anterior and posterior side has the same name. That is antebrachial. So literally before the arm. The wrist we refer to as the carpal region. And you might know that the bones of the wrist are called carpals. There's a term for the thumb, the pollex, not used very often. The palm of the hand, you probably know, that's the palmar region. And the digits are the phalanges. So this is then the phalangeal region. This weird term actually comes from the Greek, referring to a line of battle or a battle array. So I guess these are your soldiers or something? That's just weird. The front of the knee is named for the bone itself that's there. Most people know the patella, so that's the patellar region. The front of the lower leg is a tricky one. It's called the crural region. Crural just refers to leg or leg-like. And you'll see that word and the root word crus in a lot of other anatomical terms. So anything that is leg-like, you'll see that root in there. The ankle region is known as the tarsal region. And we get a repeat here. The toes are also referred to as the phalangeal region. And we do have a term for the big toe, the hallux. Oh, and by the way, this is the anterior view. The foot region altogether we refer to as pedal. The front of the thigh is referred to as the femoral region. And of course, the femur is the bone you find there. The area where the external genitalia are, we refer to as the pubic region. A larger region which encompasses the pubic region is called the inguinal region or the groin. And the entire region, which is inferior to the abdominal region, is referred to as the pelvic region. The hip right here we call coxal. The region around your navel or your belly button is the umbilical region. This whole large area here is the abdominal region. The breast area is referred to as the mammary region from the Latin mamma, which means mother. The chest is the thoracic region. This region here, what most people call the neck, is the cervical region. Your nose is the nasal region. The ear is the otic region. The cheek is the buccal region. If you know some Romance languages, you might know the term bocca or bouche comes from the same root. And finally, the eye is the orbital or ocular region. All right, we made it to the posterior side. The highest point of the shoulder is the acromial region. If you feel around your shoulder blade in the back, you'll feel this bit that sticks out. That's the acromial process. So that is literally the highest point. The whole of the back we refer to as the dorsal region or the dorsal side, the backside. The posterior side of the arm gets the same term as the anterior. That's the brachial region. And the elbow messes people up. That is the olecranal region. That comes from two Greek components. Olein refers to the elbow and kranon refers to the head or skull. So literally it means the elbow head. The lower back, most people know this one, is the lumbar region. And inferior to that is the sacral region, which literally comes from the Latin sacralis, meaning sacred. So your sacrum and your pelvis are sacred. All right, this region is the same as the anterior side. This is the antebrachial region. The entire region of the hand is referred to as the manual region. So you think about manual dexterity. All right, this region most people know, that is the gluteal region. And again, like the anterior side, this is the femoral region. This is a tricky one. The area behind the knee is the popliteal region. Popliteal is Latin for behind the knee. Sorry. This region, which most people call the calf, is the sural region. Sural is just Latin for calf. The heel of the foot is the calcaneal region, named for the bone, the calcaneus bone, which is the heel of the foot. The bottom of the foot is referred to as the plantar region. And of course, all of this is going to be the lower limb. And all of the arm we refer to as the upper limb. I know those are tricky, right? And again, now we get a posterior view of the neck, which is the cervical region. And the entire head we refer to as the cephalic region. And those are your body regions. As always, I hope it was helpful. If it was, please slam some buttons below. And I will see you in the next video. Good luck.